Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. I'm talking about ratios and rates today. When you write a ratio, you're comparing two numbers that have the same unit of measure. And you always want to reduce to the lowest terms, but your answer should be a fraction. So even if you have a 1 underneath, you want to leave that on there. There are other acceptable ways to write ratios. What I'm looking for in our class is the fraction notation read as 5 to 7. But you could actually write 5 to 7, and sometimes people use the colon 5 to 7. Those are all ways to write ratios. And then you always want to reduce to lowest terms, and you want to make sure that you're using the same unit. So in the example number A, there are 2 weeks of work for every 4 days of downtime. Well, 2 weeks is 14 days, and so instead of saying 2 to 4, which these are different units, I want to change the weeks into days. So there's 14 days. And then I say 14 instead of 2 weeks, 14 days to 4 days. And then I would reduce that to lowest terms and say 7/2 days. There's 7 to 2. In other words, there's 7 days of work for every 2 days off. Okay. B, there was $15.45 of public donations for every $150.50 donated by the company. Those units are the same. It's money, dollars. When you write a ratio, though, you can't have decimals mixed up in your fraction. And so you get rid of decimals by multiplying by some powers of 10. Powers of 10, remember, are 10, 100, 1,000, etc. So whatever stated first in a ratio is what we put on the top. So 12.45 on top and 150.50 on the bottom. And then I can't leave it this way because there's decimals inside the fraction. I want to move that decimal point 2 places. So I multiply by 100 because 100 has 2 zeros, and that means I'm going to move my decimal point 2 places to the right. That gives me 1,245 over 15,050. And then, of course, I have to reduce that, and you can divide both of those by 5 to reduce that, and it ends up with $249 for every $3,010, $249 of public donations for every $3,010 from the company. So ratios, we are comparing units that are the same. All right, so here's another one. She had 1.5 hours of break time for 9 hours of work. Well, these are already in the same unit, hours and hours, but we can't have a fraction inside of a fraction. So this is how this looks to start with, is we have 1.5/9. She had 1.5 hours of break time for every 9 hours of work. So we want to change that into an improper fraction. That gives us 3/2/9. When you see a fraction bar, we do a lot of things with fractions. It means division. Now it looks like a ratio, but really in the end, it's a division. So we are going to say 3/2 / 9. That's what that really says. And then to divide by 9, we multiply by its reciprocal, which is 1/9. And then we cross cancel and reduce and all that, and we get 1/6 hours. That means she has 1 hour of break for every 6 hours of work. So that's a ratio, same units, reduced to lowest terms, no decimals in it, and no fractions inside the fraction. Okay, and then we have rates. And rates are different because they're comparing two things with different units of measure. Common rates are miles per gallon, cost per ounce, those kind of things. When you write a rate, you want the denominator to be 1. So we divide the two numbers out, like basically get rid of that denominator altogether. So, example, there were 50 cars for every 12 drivers. We start off with 50 over 12, and we divide that and say, okay, there was 4.17 cars per driver. Notice I have 2 units here because they weren't the same to begin with. She drove 352 miles on 10.6 gallons of gas. 352 divided by 10.6. That gives us 33.21 miles per gallon. Now, for my purposes, I was rounding all of these to the hundreds. You always have to read the directions your instructor gives you of how far do they want you to round. But in general, for my classes, if it doesn't say, hundreds is a good place to go, not to the whole number. That usually is not what people want. Okay, he paid $4.52 for 40 ounces of juice. What we're interested in here is the cost per ounce of juice. So 452 divided by 40, and that gives you $0.11 per ounce, or you could say that's 11 cents per ounce. All right, that is rates and ratios. Have a fantastic day.